We're asked to plot the fractions 1/4, 3/4, 6/4, and 10/4 on the number line, then write any improper fractions as mixed numbers. Notice for all the fractions, the denominators are 4. Because of this, we will cut each length equal to 1 unit into 4 equally sized parts or lengths. Because the length between 0 and 1 is equal to 1 unit, we will cut this length into 4 equally sized parts or lengths. And the same thing for the length between 1 and 2, and the length between 2 and 3. By doing this, the length between tick marks is now equal to 1/4 of a unit. And now we can plot the given fractions. 1/4 is located 1/4 of a unit to the right of 0, which would be here. 3/4 is located 3/4 of a unit to the right of 0. Starting at 0 and counting by 1/4, we have 0, 1/4, 2/4, and 3/4. We can also think of this as 3 copies of 1/4. Next we have 6/4. So let's start at 3/4 and count by 4ths. 3/4, 4/4, which is equal to 1, 5/4, and 6/4. 6/4 is equal to 6 copies of 1/4. And then finally for 10/4, we'll start at 6/4 and count by 1/4. 6/4, 7/4, 8/4, which is equal to 2, 9/4, and 10/4. Before we express the improper fractions as mixed numbers, two of these fractions can simplify. Fractions simplify if the numerator and denominator share a common factor other than 1. Notice for the fraction 6/4, 6 and 4 share a common factor of 2, and for the fraction 10/4, 10 and 4 also share a common factor of 2. When a fraction simplifies, it means it can be expressed using larger sized pieces, or in this case, larger sized lengths. To see how these two fractions simplify, let's cut the length of each unit now into 2 equally sized parts or lengths rather than 4. So here's the length between 0 and 1, which is equal to 1 unit. Let's cut this into 2 equally sized parts or lengths. And the same thing for the length between 1 and 2, and 2 and 3. Notice by doing this now, the length between tick marks is equal to 1/2 of a unit. So we have 0, 1/2, 2/2, which is equal to 1, 3/2, 4/2, which is equal to 2, 5/2, and 6/2, which is equal to 3. Now looking at 6/4, we can see 6/4 is equal to or equivalent to 3/2. 3/2 is a simplified form of 6/4. More traditionally, to simplify 6/4, because 6 and 4 share a common factor of 2, we would divide the numerator and denominator by 2. Notice how this does give us 3/2. And notice that 10/4 is equivalent to 5/2. 5/2 is a simplified form of 10/4. Or more traditionally, because 10 and 4 share a common factor of 2, to simplify, we divide the numerator and denominator by 2, which does give us 5/2. Notice how the fractions of 1/4 and 3/4 cannot be expressed with the denominator of 2, because 1/4 and 3/4 do not simplify. And now we'll write the improper fractions as mixed numbers. An improper fraction is a fraction where the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator, which means 6/4 and 10/4 are improper fractions and can be expressed as mixed numbers. Notice how 6/4 is greater than 1. If we begin at 1 and count by 1/4, we have 1, 1 and 1/4, 1 and 2/4, which shows that 6/4 is equal to 1 and 2/4 as a mixed number. And looking at 10/4, notice how 10/4 is greater than 2. If we begin at 2 and count by 1/4, we have 2, 2 and 1/4, 2 and 2/4. You may also have noticed that 2/4 does simplify. Looking at the number line, 2/4 would be here, which is equal to 1/2, which means we can also write the mixed number for 6/4 as 1 1/2. We can also write the mixed number for 10/4 as 2 1/2. Looking at the partitions equal to half of a unit, notice that 6/4, if we go back to 1 and count by 1/2, so we have 1, and then 1 1/2. 1 1/2 is equal to 6/4. And for 10/4, if we begin at 2 and count by 1/2, so we have 2 1/2, which equals 10/4. I hope you found this helpful.